स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम कर रहे हैं आंसर शीट गिवन बाय द सीबीएसई फॉर द क्वेश्चन पेपर टू ऑल द टीचर्स और द चेकर्स। जो चेक करते हैं वो किसको देख के करते हैं और सीबीएसई क्या आंसर्स देती है। हमारे पास क्वेश्चन पेपर शुरू हो रहा है। ये रही हमारे पास सीरीज ONS सीरीज सेट वन। कोड इज 55/1/S। यहाँ पर आपको रोल नंबर लिखना है। हेयर यू हैव टू राइट योर रोल नंबर। ओके, नाउ द फर्स्ट डायरेक्शन इज प्लीज चेक दैट द क्वेश्चन पेपर कंटेन्स 16 प्रिंटेड पेजेस। कोड नंबर इज गिवन ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन पेपर, शुड बी रिटन ऑन द टाइटल पेज ऑफ द आंसर बुक। अभी देखते हैं। प्लीज चेक दैट दिस क्वेश्चन पेपर कंटेन्स 26 क्वेश्चंस। प्लीज राइट डाउन द सीरियल नंबर ऑफ द क्वेश्चन बिफोर अटेम्प्टिंग इट। सीरियल नंबर जरूर लिखना है। 15 मिनट्स टाइम शैल बी अलॉटेड टू रीड दिस क्वेश्चन पेपर। द क्वेश्चन पेपर विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड एट 10:15 AM थ्रू आउट इंडिया। From 10:15 to 10:30, the student will read the question paper only and will not write any answer on the answer book during this period. Now, physics theory for 70 marks, maximum marks is 70, time allotted is 3 hours. There are general instructions. General instructions are, all questions are compulsory, 26 questions in all. There we have 5 sections, section A, B, C, D and section E. Section A has 5 questions, 1 mark each. Section B has 5 questions, 2 marks each. Section C has 12 questions, 3 marks each. And Section D has 1 value based question of 4 marks. Section E contains 3 questions of 5 marks each. Now about the choices. There is no overall choice. However, an internal choice has been provided in 1 question of 2 marks, 1 question of 3 marks and all the 3 questions of 5 marks weightage. You have to attempt only one of the choices in such questions. Okay. Now there are physical constants. Ye hamare paas physical constants hain, jinki value di hui hai. Now comes the answer sheet portion. This is the answer sheet. Name of the subject physics. Subject code 042. Name of exam Saturday. Date is 05/03/2016. Medium of instruction English. This is the code number. And this is the set number. You have to darken it. Person with disabilities, yes or no. Type of disability, if writer is provided with for visually challenged students, this space you don't have to fill. Now, we are going to see how the marking scheme tells us what to write and what not to write. First question, two wires, one of copper and other of manganin, have the same resistance and equal length, which is thicker and why? This is the marking scheme given by the CBSE to the teachers or the checkers or the those teachers who check it. The first row column is the question number. In set 1, question number 1 is same as question number 3. In set 2 is same as question number 2 in set 3. This column is the expected answer or the value points and the marks allotted for every step. These are the marks allotted. Then that sum total of all the marks in the end. So the answer is of the first is manganin and the second is R is rho L by A. As rho increases, A also increases. Alternately, resistance RC is rho C L by A. Resistance of manganin is rho M L by A. We have the ratio. As rho M is more than rho C, AM is more than AC. This is the alternate answer. Either you write this or this. Okay. Now, next question is, the power factor of an AC circuit is 0.5. What is the phase difference? Phase angle is 60 degree. If the student write cos phi 0.5, give half mark. Okay. So you should write something or the other. In which situation is there a displacement current but no conduction current between the plates of capacitor during charging or discharging? 1 mark. Or in the region of time varying electric field? Same, 1 mark. Next, question number 4. Name the logic gates P and Q. P is NOT gate and this Q is OR gate, half mark each, making it 1 mark. Define the term relaxation time in a conductor. So the definition of relaxation time, the average time between successive collisions of electrons in a conductor is known as the relaxation time, 1 mark. What is electrostatic shielding? Now we have section B. Section B has 5 questions of 2 marks each. Electrostatic shielding is for half mark. The field inside a conductor is zero. This is called as electrostatic shielding. How is this property used in actual practice? For sensitive instruments are shielded from outside electrical influences by enclosing them in a hollow conductor. Is the potential in the cavity charged conductor zero?
No.
Potential inside is not zero, or potential is a constant. Half mark, total 2 marks. I am repeating again, these are the answers provided by the CBSE. You should know after reading this what is asked and how you are going to write and how much you are going to write. State two properties of electromagnetic waves. We have two properties, 1 mark, and showing EM wave have momentum, 1 mark. How can we show EM wave carry momentum? Any two properties, transverse nature, does not get deflected by electromagnetic field, same speed in vacuum for all waves, no material medium for propagation, they are refracted, diffracted and polarized, any two properties you have to write for 1 mark. Next, electric charges present in a plane kept normal to the direction of propagation of EM wave can be set and sustained in motion by the electric and magnetic field of the EM wave. The charges acquire energy and momentum from the waves. 1 mark. Or we say we can write radiation pressure. Electromagnetic waves exert radiation pressure, hence they carry momentum. 2 marks. Question number 8. Write briefly the underlying principle used in Davison and German experiment to verify the wave nature of electrons experimentally. So principle, 1 mark. Principle says that the diffraction effects are observed for beams of electrons scattered by the crystals. 1/2 mark. What is the de Broglie wavelength of an electron with kinetic energy 120 electron volt? So you can write lambda, this is already calculated, root V, put root V 120, lambda is 0.112 nanometer. This is another alternate method. Okay. Now, 9th question. Write the function of a transducer and a repeater. Transducer 1 mark, repeater 1 mark, you can read the definitions here. 10th question. In the ground state of hydrogen atom, its Bohr radius is given as this much. The atom is excited such that the radius becomes this much. Find the value of the principal quantum number n and the total energy En in this excited state. Or the energy levels are shown here. Which of the shown transitions will result in the emission of photon of wavelength 275 nanometer? You attempt whichever seems easier. So radius is r naught n square. So r naught, r is equal to r naught into n square. That means n comes out to be 2. This is for 1 mark. Finding the total energy, another 1 mark. Total energy is this much upon 2 ka square. 2 square is minus 3.4. 2 marks. This is another method. Sorry, this is the other question. Now, next is calculation of the energy of photon is hc by lambda. We put all the values and that comes out to be 4.5 electron volt. Or what you can do is the energy is hc by lambda in joules upon e comes in electron volt. So you calculate this much value as your homework and then divide it by lambda. That comes out to be 1224 electron volt upon lambda. Or 12.24, I suppose. Okay. Now it is 275 or 12.1224 upon lambda is 275. If lambda is in nanometer, this comes out to be in electron volt. This comes out to be 4.5 electron volt. Okay. Now, next is section C. Section C has 3 mark questions. 12 questions will be there. Derive an expression for the electric field intensity on the equatorial line. Okay. What is the direction? So the diagram, this diagram has 1 mark, derivation has 1.5, direction of equatorial 1/2 mark. Diagram 1 mark, here is the derivation 1.5, then 1/2 mark for the direction. You have to show the direction opposite to the dipole moment. Next we have a numerical. A parallel plate capacitor C1 has a charge Q, is connected to an identical uncharged capacitor C2 in series. What would be the charge accumulated on C2? Okay. Now, part A's answer is to find the charge accumulated in C2 is 1/2 mark. The answer is 0. Next, 3 identical capacitors in series. In series, you must be wondering if we have something like this. We have a charge Q. So, in plus Q. Here minus Q, if they are connected in series, then over here shall be plus Q, over here minus Q. What would be the charge accumulated on the capacitor? C2. The total charge accumulated was 0, now it will be 0 plus Q and minus Q. Next, three identical capacitors, each of capacitance 3 microfarad, are connected in turn in series and in parallel of common voltage V volt. Find out the ratio of energies. In series, the capacitance will be 1 micro. Parallel, it will be 9 micro. Energy is half CV square. So, half 1 into V square, half 9 into V square, ratio is 1:9. Next question, 13th. Define the term intensity of radiation in photon picture. So, intensity is equal to the energy of the photons, normally per unit area, per unit time. B. Plot a graph showing the variation of photocurrent versus collector potential for I1, I2, I3. Two of which I1 and I2 have the same frequency nu. So, I1 and I2 have same frequency, different intensity, and then we have third frequency nu1 greater than nu. So, if nu1 is greater, this will be the greater frequency. Explain the nature of curves on the basis of Einstein's equation. We can explain this on the Einstein's equation. The stopping potential is same if frequency is same, intensity are different. The saturation current are shown because I1 is greater than I2 is greater than I3. These are the saturation current. The greater the intensity, more the saturation current. 14th question. Explain briefly the process of emission of light by LED. To explain LED, we have it here. We can also draw a diagram that is additional, optional. Which semiconductors are preferred to make LEDs? Gallium arsenide, phosphide, anyone. And why? Because the band gap is 1.8 to 3 electron volt for these materials. Next is two advantages of LED over conventional incandescent lamp. Low operational voltage, fast action, no warm-up time, nearly monochromatic, long life. All the answers of the NCERT ruggedness, fast on-off switching capacity. Now, we have a numerical. You can read this numerical and just see how much you have to write. You can pause the animation or the video and you can calculate it. A capacitor. A unknown capacitor, resistor 100 ohm, and inductor L 4 upon pi square is connected in series to 200 volt and 50 hertz. Calculate the value of capacitance and impedance when the current is in phase with voltage, that means resonance. At resonance, C is equal to 1 by L omega square, so we calculate the capacitance. Impedance is Z equal to R, that is 100 ohm. Power is E square by R or IRMS square, R or I square into R. That comes out to be 400 watt. Then 16th question, we have a numerical. For a glass prism, mu root 3, the angle of minimum deviation, delta, is equal to the angle A. Calculate the angle of the prism, 1.5 and 1.5 marks. So, mu is this formula, prism formula. So, D is A itself, A plus A is 2A, 2A by 2. S 2a by 2, sin a by 2 is 2, cos a by 2 is root 3, mu is root 3, that means 2 cos a by 2 is root 3, cos a by 2 is root 3 by 2, a comes out to be 60 degrees, 1.5 marks. Next, draw a ray diagram when the incident ray falls normally on one of the two equal sides of a right angled isosceles triangle prism having refractive index mu is 0.3. We draw a diagram, then we can calculate it over here. Okay, so like this, this is 90, this is, these two are 45 degrees. If a normal ray comes, this becomes 45, 45 is greater than 35 degrees or 30 degrees. Sin IC is 1 by root 3, is less than 1 by root 2, that means IC, that is less than 45, 45 is our I, greater than IC, TIR, it goes like this. 17th question, plot a graph showing the variation of binding energy per nucleon. This is the binding energy per nucleon as a function of mass number. This is the mass number, that NCERT graph. Which property of nuclear force explains the appropriate constancy of binding energy in this range from 30 to 170? The constancy is given by the saturation property or short range. How does one explain the release of energy? We will be writing about the fission and the fusion. The final system is more tightly bound. When heavy nucleus undergoes a nuclear fission, there is a release of energy. Now, during fusion, the final system is more tightly bound. when light nuclei undergo nuclear fusion, hence release of energy. Alternately, you can write this also. Next, draw a circuit diagram of a CE amplifier using a NPN transistor. This is the circuit diagram, NCRT one. This will give you 2 marks here. Derive an expression. So, these two equations for current gain beta AC, or if the student writes beta AC is this much, award full credit 1 mark, makes up 3 marks. 19th question. Name the phenomena on which working of an optical fiber is based. That is TIR. Necessary condition. Optically denser to optically rarer, and angle of I is in the denser medium should be greater than the critical angle. Draw a label diagram of optical fiber. This is the NCRT one. Okay. Mention any 3 applications of the internet. Explain one of these in detail. Now, we don't have this for 2018. 21st question. 2 harmonic waves of monochromatic light Y1 and Y2, phase difference phi, are superimposed on each other. Show that the maximum intensity is 4 times the intensity due to each slit. Hence, write the condition for constructive and destructive interference in terms of the phase angle phi. So, resultant displacement Y1 plus Y2, we are going to add this much. Amplitude is, this is the amplitude, 2a cos phi by 2. Intensity is amplitude square, 4i naught cos square phi by 2, where i naught is a square. The maxima is phi is 2n pi, okay, cos square phi by 2 is 1, okay, or phi is equal to 2n pi. And the minima, destructive, for destructive, I is minimum, that is 0, cos square phi is 0, or phi is this much, or we can write, if this is n into 2 pi, this can be written as n plus half into 2 pi. That is an easier. Always n and n plus half. Now, next question. Question number 22. Mention 2 properties of soft iron due to which it is preferred for making an electromagnet. 2 properties of soft iron. They are low coercivity and high permeability. State Gauss's law. How is it different from Gauss's law in electrostatics? Magnetism. Magnetism Gauss's law, then electrostatic Gauss's law. The difference. Magnetic monopoles do not exist. Magnetic monopoles always exist in pairs, north and south. Next is, in OR, derive an expression for the axial magnetic field of a finite solenoid of length 2L, radius R, current I. Under what condition does the field become equivalent to that produced by a bar magnet? We have a full whole derivation as in the NCRT. Solenoid, because of one coil, we integrate from minus L to plus L. When R is very much greater than A, we have this expression. Magnetic moment M is equal to NIA. Then B is mu naught upon 4 pi 2m by R cube or X cube. So, along the axial line, it is similar to that of a bar magnet for far off points. Section D is value based. This is in Hindi. Then we have, you can read this out. Okay. It will take some time. You can pause the video and you can read it. Write the 2 values which Hari displays. Any 2 values. 1 plus 1, 2 marks. They are for free. Free. Why is it that a bird can sit over a suspended live wire without any harm, whereas touching it on the ground will give it a fatal shock? Okay. Current passes through 2 points only when there is a potential difference between them. As far as the bird does not touch the ground, there is no current through the bird. The 2 values are caring, helpful, presence of mind, or any other 2 relevant values. The electric power from a power plant is set up to a very high voltage before transmitting it to distant consumers. Right reason, to minimize power loss during transmission. All 4 marks. Okay. Now comes section E. The last section will have 3 questions. These are the long questions and their long answers. Find the magnitude and direction of current in 1 ohm resistor. 2 cells, two circuits, the third circuit, we will be doing it by Kirchhoff's laws. Then there's a question on potentiometer, X and Y. This was done in earlier papers. Okay. So I'm just scrolling down. Then we have OR. Another question, similar question, two loops here, another loop here, Kirchhoff's laws. Using Kirchhoff's rule, calculate the current in arm AC, in this arm. On what principle does the meter bridge work? Okay. Why are the metal strips used in the bridge? So, here is the solution. We draw the diagram again. These are the equations. First loop, second loop, maybe after two loops it comes. Okay. Now, this answer is for the other one, the potentiometer. Then the OR part, then the numerical. First loop, second loop. Then the meter bridge condition. Meter bridge strip reason, area more, resistance less, voltage drop less, power loss less. Next, question number 25. Express Biot-Savart law in vector form. This is the Biot-Savart law in vector form. Use it to obtain the expression for the magnetic field at an axial point. Axial point magnetic field, field derivation is here. And then find the ratio of the magnitude when x is r root 3. This is the derivation. Then we have a diagram. Here the diagram is for half marks. Then we put it, x is equal to, over here, d, or x is equal to 3r, root 3r. Okay. Then we calculate the ratio of the magnetic fields. The second part. Consider a beam of charged particles with varying speeds. Show how crossed electric and magnetic fields can be used to select charged particles at a particular velocity. That is the velocity selector. Velocity selection condition, V is equal to E by B. Okay. Now, next is, name another device, machine or machine which uses crossed electric and magnetic fields. Cyclotron. What does this machine do? Accelerates charged particles. What are the functions of magnetic field? Magnetic field makes them go around in a circle. Electric field accelerates them. Where do these fields exist in this machine? The electric field is from right to left, or left to right, and the magnetic field is into the page or out of the page. Write about their natures. Okay. Now, magnetic field is uniform and electric field is oscillating or alternating in nature. Now comes the last question. 26th. When a parallel beam of monochromatic source of light lambda is incident on a single slit of width A, show how the diffraction pattern is formed at the screen by the interference of the wave that's from the slit. This is the diffraction derivation. Show that besides the central maxima at theta equal to 0, secondary maxima are observed at n plus half lambda by A and minima n lambda by A. Why do secondary maxima get weaker in intensity with increasing n? Okay. Now, this is rarer to denser derivation. Then we have how the focal length of a convex lens changes with increase in wavelength. And what happens to the focal length of convex lens when it is immersed in water? Refractive index of material is greater than that of water. First derivation, we have to derive the diffraction contributions from different wavelets with proper phase difference. Then the central maxima. We can also draw this graph over here. Okay. Now, secondary maxima keeps on weaker intensity with increasing, and this is because the first secondary maxima, the net contribution is only from 1/3 of the incident wavefront, and second secondary maxima is 1/5. Next is the derivation from rarer to denser medium at a convex spherical surface. This is the derivation from NCRT, figure from NCRT. Now, focal length increases with increases in wavelength. Mu is always lambda naught upon lambda m. Increase in wavelength means mu decreases. Mu decreases, so f increases. Okay.